You're watching TechRadar. My name's Basil, and the Samsung Galaxy S9 Plus is here. I've used it in the UK. Matt Swider has extensively reviewed it in the US, so we can tell you exactly what we think and what we think of the two variants, the Exynos and the Snapdragon versions. The Samsung Galaxy S9 Plus is a successor to the S8 Plus. It's got a curved glass back, curved glass front, IP68 water and dust resistant, just like its predecessor. This time around though, you've got stereo speakers. You've also got a center mounted fingerprint scanner around the back. You've also carried forward some of the things that people really, really liked. That curved OLED display, and there's a 3.5mm headphone jack on here too. They haven't lost that one just yet. This phone feels very, very good in the hands. Super premium, super solid, but it definitely does like fingerprints. As for the screen, it is jaw-dropping. The Super AMOLED display at Quad HD resolution and 6.2 inches makes it all come together beautifully. Over 500 pixels per inch means it's nice and sharp as well. Generally speaking, the look of this thing from design to screen is relatively faultless, even though very little, if anything, of note has changed aside from that fingerprint scanner since its predecessor. So if it ain't broke, don't fix it, and that is definitely something Samsung hasn't done. Tried to change a winning formula. So if there hasn't been much change from a design point of view, what about a user interface point of view? Yes, here's where Samsung has tried to overhaul things a little bit. The core UI is really similar, home screens and applications tray, etc. But when you deep dive into it, you find things like AR emoji. This is Samsung's answer to Animoji. It creates a little caricature of you. Once you've got your avatar created on your phone, it can then look at your face, figure out what you're doing with your face, and then turn that into a GIF or a picture. It's very easy to share out these AR emojis, and you can also change from your face to an animal of some description and various other people. It has no preference as to whose face you're using when you are creating your AR emoji. Then there's Bixby. This is your voice assistant that recognizes your voice most of the time, and it can also look at stuff through the camera and translate things. It can tell you how many calories are in foods you point your camera at, and it can do all of these things well, but not brilliantly. And actually, in many cases, not brilliantly enough for you to want to be using it in day-to-day life. It's a step in the right direction, showcasing capabilities, but they just don't work as smoothly as I would personally like them to. This definitely feels like a step in the AI direction, but the fact you have to be connected to the internet to use Bixby is a pain in the tail end. One thing that does work a lot better is the biometric security story here. Across the board, it combines face recognition with iris scanning, with fingerprint scanning to give you a solution that when you just look at your phone will work very, very well. Oftentimes I came to fingerprint scan and it actually had already done it with my face. It might not have the success rate of Apple's Face ID, but given the fact you've also got that fingerprint scanner in there, biometrically I think this thing gets a serious thumbs up. The Samsung Galaxy S9 and S9 Plus also have stereo speakers. These are 40% louder than the mono speaker on the bottom of the S8 and S8 Plus. What's also cool is there's Dolby Atmos technology on board, and it is tuned by AKG. So there's a lot going on here. In real world use, it does sound very impressive. It isn't always quite as crisp as the iPhone X, but there are also times when the iPhone X sounds a little bit shriller. So it's a really solid effort that makes the Samsung Galaxy series finally competitive on a sound front. Powered along by a Snapdragon 845 in the US and an Exynos 9810 here in the UK and in other regions outside the US, power is definitely not an issue on this phone. Whichever version you're going to get, you'll be able to do things like 960 frame per second slow-mo, and you can also whiz through any game you throw at it. It can multitask well, it can also shoot 4K video with ease, edit 4K video. This thing's going to fly. There have been a few discrepancies posted around the Snapdragon and an Exynos version, so it'll be really interesting to see what discrepancies emerge after people have used them for an extensive amount of time. You can also pick it up with either 64 or 128 gigabytes of internal storage, and there's micro SD card expandability as well. There are three cameras on the Samsung Galaxy S9 Plus. There are two around the back, one at the front. The rear cameras are 12 megapixel sensors, one with a 2x zoom. The primary camera though is the same as found on the S9, and it's special because it's the first on a smartphone that has a variable aperture. f1.5, the widest aperture found on a smartphone, or f2.4, depending on the lighting situations. In low light, performance is excellent here. It's really, really good. I was impressed. But that said, it's all at the expense of a bit of detail. You get a fair bit of motion blur if your subject moves while you're taking the shot as well, even just a little bit. That's probably down to the aperture enabling a longer shutter speed, which is a good thing, especially if you can keep your hand steady. That said, in good lighting, pictures are good, but they are not mind-blowing. And this is as a result of a fair bit of over-processing on Samsung's part. Samsung brightens the situation up a fair bit, which can produce some pleasing pictures for a lot of people, but they are categorically less accurate. Still, you do have a ton of shooting modes, from Pro mode that enables you to manually change that aperture right through to that AR emoji mode I was talking about that lets you slap a caricature all over your face. There's a ton to do if you do want to play with this camera, and that's also true of video. Sure, it can record up to 4K video, etc., but it can also record up to 960 frames per second slow-mo. The interface is much smarter than that of Sony's. Unfortunately, the results are very similar in terms of low light. It's really, really unusable. In fact, even in middling light, you have to be in the brightest conditions in order to make the most of this. We also compared the portrait mode of the Galaxy S9 with the iPhone X and the Google Pixel 2 XL. Check out that video to see how it did. Here's a little hint though, it didn't fare the best. And despite having in many situations the best foreground background detection, it was the overall processing that let it down. When it comes to the battery, 3,500 milliamps will more than likely get you through a day, but that's pretty much it. In our tests, while we couldn't draw anything conclusive, the Snapdragon version could be a little bit better in terms of power saving around the radios, so when using 4G, etc., and the Exynos version's potentially better around using the camera. Everything else seemed pretty even Stevens. So like I said, one day out of this thing, very, very unlikely more than that. So what do we think of the Samsung Galaxy S9 Plus? This is an excellent looking phone with a really good looking camera. It's also waterproof, has stereo speakers as well. And generally, you can't fault it too much until you consider the fact that S8 Plus is still on the market. If you're looking to upgrade, you would be doing so for those stereo speakers and the better placed fingerprint scanner. AR Emoji and Bixby aren't enough to differentiate it from our point of view. It does have a better low light camera. That second 2x zoom camera also helps as well. And if you get the 128GB version, you do also have some additional storage. Battery life isn't a whole lot better, and so might not be worth the upgrade if you have an S8 Plus. If you're jumping over from a Galaxy S7 though, it will be a worthy contender. Hopefully you enjoyed this review. If you did, make sure you check out all our videos, including our bokeh mode comparison. TechRadar.com is your destination. Thanks for watching.